Cindy Lauper has won cash and prizes totaling $61,590. Today, one of our contestants can win a personal computer, a diamond ring, a grandfather clock, or a trip to Paris, and continue a journey towards a fortune in cash and prizes, including this Austin Healey replica, and $50,000 in cash. In total, over $100,000 on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim Perry.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Delighted to have you with us. Good to have you with us for a very important show. Let's first of all introduce that champion, Cindy Barr. Hi, Cindy.
Hi, Jim.
$61,590 in cash and prizes. And for any of our friends at home who were not with us on the last show, Cindy, clear that winner's board. And of course, once you do that, as well you know, you got your first opportunity to take a risk. Cindy has chosen to take that risk. She's risking all of the prizes she's picked up on that board in order to add $50,000 in cash if you win this show. Now, Cindy, just to get you a little relaxed, you are not risking. I think you're over $12,000 in cash and prizes from the Fame Game and from Instant Bargains and Sales Surprises. Those, of course, you are not risking. You are risking those 10 major prizes. Of course, they're big, $13,000 in cash and a sports car, among others. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Any doubts that you made the right decision about going for it?
No, I feel good.
All right. Good luck.
Thank you.
And here to try to stop her from getting that $50,000 in cash, Sylla Bartholomew will introduce the players. Hi there, Sylla.
Hi.
I know you got a couple of good people to try to stop her.
Yes. This man spends a lot of time in court. From Denver, Colorado, here's Doug Chester.
Hi there, Doug.
And this lady gets wrapped up in herself from Aspen, Colorado. Give a big hand to Jasmine Tiger.
Hi there, Jasmine. Be a little later with some bargains. Jasmine, you get all wrapped up in yourself.
That's right, Jim. I knit my own sweaters.
Oh.
In fact, I was going to wear one on the show today, but I got unraveled.
Sweater, a Jasmine Tiger original unraveled?
A Jasmine Tiger original unraveled on me.
Okay, you must do very well at it, though. Nice to have you here.
Thank you.
You spent a lot of time in court, obviously a lawyer.
No, Jim. My court is a tennis court. I'm a professional tennis umpire.
Oh.
So I travel around the country officiating in major tournaments around the United States and Canada.
That sounds. Do the players all yell at you?
Once in a while.
Nice to have you here, Doug. Good luck. I don't have to tell the two of you up against a great champion. And $20 starts all three players off. Most important match, get started with this. In Gone with the Wind, who played the role of Rhett Butler? Cindy.
Gable.
That's right. Clark Gable it is. $5 for the correct answer. Cindy goes to 25. What did your doctor diagnose as normal from test results of 2020?
Cindy. Vision.
Vision, eyesight, you're exactly right. She's quick with that buzzer. And two in a row. If you are out celebrating wildly, according to the phrase, what... Cindy?
Painting the town red.
What color are you painting the town? Of course, red it is. And three in a row right off the bat. And a $15 lead. All she has to do is hang on to that lead, and she's $50,000 richer. In what garden did Adam meet Eve?
Cindy. The Garden of Eden.
That's the one. And Cindy doubles the score on Doug and Jasmine. On what part of his body does a Frenchman wear his... Doug?
Head.
His chapeau? You're right. Doug figured I'd better get in there quick. You were right. You got five. You go to 25. Time for an instant bargain. Player in the lead can buy bargain merchandise. Now, Cindy has picked up a lot of things, and as I say, she's not risking those things. Cindy, $15 lead. You're going for $50,000 in cash. Along the way, would your handsome husband, Steve, like to wear something like this?
Cindy added a touch of class to the wardrobe with Knight, a soft and elegant coat for the gentleman. This classic leather fly jacket is luxuriously trimmed for the warmth of nature's own coat. Furnished by Knight of New Zealand, and it's normally priced at $350. Today on Sale of the Century, it's yours for only $6.
$6. Your husband will look great in that jacket.
That's gorgeous.
You know, I was talking to him after the last show, and he said if there's anything he wanted, it was a jacket just like that.
Yeah,
and $350 a jacket would cost. Now, I know you're going for some big things. You have a $15 lead. If you bought the jacket for $6, you would still have a $9 lead. All you have to do is win for the $50,000. I would love to make it easy for you to make that decision, Cindy. So, of course... $500 in cash.
Yeah.
A jacket, leather jacket, lined.
You could go out
lined with $500 in cash, and you still have a $9 lead going once. Going twice. No sale. Couldn't interest her with the jacket. Sorry about that, Steve. To add to his three Grammys, this music man received an honorary doctorate of music from his alma mater, Tuskegee Institute. He's now Dr. Lionel.
Richie,
yes, Dr. Lionel it is. And you get another prize, Cindy the 45. In what state are you if you're vacationing in the Catskills? Cindy.
Alabama.
No. Oh, you were close. New York. New York State, the Catskills, you lose five. First backward step of the champion in a while, and still that $15 lead over Doug. His hunting skill earned frontiersman William Cody his famous nickname.
Cindy. Buffalo Bill.
Buffalo Bill, as Cindy beats Doug with the buzzer and goes back to 45. Well, if Jasmine and Doug are going to catch her, they may need some money up there on the fame game board. $5 and $10 money cards up there. Looking for a famous thing. I am a television show that premiered in 1981. My original title was Oil, but it was changed. Cindy.
Dallas.
No. Oh, a break for your opponent. Cindy's out of the rest of the question. We'll clear the board. Continue for Doug and Jasmine. My star runs his holding. Doug.
Dynasty.
Yes, indeed. The other one. Well, Doug, big ticket aboard for you, trailing by $20. What number would you like?
Number 8.
And behind number 8, we have Mystery Money Orpik again.
Tough decision, Doug. First opportunity to pick up some cash. We don't know how much. We do know there's a $5 and $10 money card up there. You're trailing by $20. What do you want to do?
I'll take the Mystery Money.
And so what do we have, Summer? $500 in cash. All right, Doug. That's yours. Yours to keep, no matter how you finish in the game. And those money cards stay up there. They could be very important in a very important match. Back to it right after this.
If you live in Los Angeles or are planning to visit the L.A. area and would like to become a contestant on Sale of the Century, please call area code 213-557-3555. And now back to Jim Perry and Tale of the Century.
Thank you, Jay. And, well, you couldn't be faint of heart if you were involved in a match like this one with Cindy going for $50,000. She does have a lead. She's a 45. Doug, who's pocketed $500, is a 25. Jasmine, a 20. We're back with this. In cooking, what's the name given to lamb over 1 year old? Cindy.
Mutton.
You are right. I think you just beat the buzzer on that one. You go to 50. What ceremonious march would the Marine Band play if President Reagan walked? Doug.
Hail to the Chief.
That's right. If he walked into the room, hail to the Chief it would be. And you're right. Doug goes to 30. What name is given to the unlawful takeover of an aircraft? Cindy.
Hijacking.
Hijacking or skyjacking. Either one acceptable. And Cindy's right for another 5. The two official languages of Ireland are, Doug?
English and Gaelic.
You got them both. Nicely done. Doug goes to 35. But, Cindy, you still have a big lead. You've got yourself a $20 lead. Oh, I remember, of all the good things you've picked up, you haven't gotten... Oh, you haven't got one of these.
Cindy, picture yourself in this. Sharp's 19-inch color TV with detachable remote control and channel flashback, permitting instant alternate viewing of 2 previously selected channels. Furnished by Sharp, and it's normally priced at $635. Today on Sale of the Century, it's yours for only $12.
Oh, Cindy, you look good on television there, Cindy.
Thank you, Jim.
And you haven't won a color television set with all the things you've won. Do you know, too, you've got a $20 lead, cost $12, you would still have an $8 lead. Do you know it's such a funny thing that this TV would come up just at a time when it also goes with $1,000 in cash? Do you know that?
Yeah.
That color TV, $635, includes $1,000 in cash, your lead would be $8. Going once, going twice, and no sale. Not going for $50,000. She didn't want it. Back with this. What name is given to a male elephant's huge incisor? Cindy. That's what the incisor teeth are. You're right for another 5. The satiric novelist who wrote Breakfast of Champions and Cindy.
Kurt Vonnegut.
Nicely done, Kurt Vonnegut. It is Cindy to 65. You've just sailed from Tampa, Florida to Veracruz, Mexico. Cindy?
The Gulf of Mexico.
That's what you cross the Gulf of Mexico. It is. Cindy hits the $70 mark. What is the opposite of a lens that is concave? Cindy.
Convex.
Nicely done, and Cindy to 75. My goodness, you got $11. This legendary Old West mail service delivered letters from Missouri, Doug.
Pony Express.
To California Pony Express it is. Doug the 40, yeah. Talking about the Pony Express, it took a very unique person, literally, to make that haul. In fact, Pony Express ran this help wanted ad. Wanted, young, skinny, wiry fellows, not over 18. Must be experienced riders, willing to risk death daily, wages $25 a week, and I love this one, orphans preferred. We'll be right back. Cindy Barr with over $61,000 in cash and prizes, risking her major prizes to add a $50,000 cash bonus, has a $35 lead. Cindy is 75. Doug has been pushing her a bit at 40. Jasmine at 20. Same game. 5, 10, and now a $15 money card on the board. Looking for a famous thing. I am a form of clothing originally made of animal hides. I reached my peak of use from the 1300s to the mid-1500s. People who made me became respected craftsmen because their skill could determine life or death for those who wore me. When leather no longer served the purpose for which I was intended, the artisans turned to metal plate. Cindy.
Shields?
No, I'm sorry. Don't say any more, Cindy. Out of the rest of the question, we will clear the board and continue for Jasmine and Doug. The artisans turned to metal plate or small rings linked together called chain mail. Jasmine.
Armor.
That's right. Suits of armor, yes. Yes, we could not accept your first answer, shield, because, of course, the shield is not worn. It is carried. A suit of armor is worn. And, Jasmine, you've got a pick of the board.
Number four.
And behind number four, we have $400.
Perfect again. Jasmine, I will tell you right now, you're trailing by $55. You might be able to make it up, or you could put $400 in your pocket.
I think the way things are going, I better take the $400.
What's the $400 in your pocket? You got it. That's yours. I'm always happy when no one goes home empty-handed. You are definitely not going home empty-handed, and you do still have time to catch up. We got a lot of questions. Cindy, of course, you're back in. Name the American first lady who didn't have to change her name when she got Cindy.
Madison?
No. Eleanor Roosevelt. Her maiden name was also Roosevelt. Champion loses 5 down to 70, still a $30 lead. Past, present, and future were the three ghosts who appeared to Cindy.
Scrooge.
That's right. It is indeed Ebenezer Scrooge. Cindy gets $5 right back. His donation of more than $5 million to charities represented the superstar singer's proceeds from his victory tour. Doug.
Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson it is. Doug B71 of the Boston goes to 45. But Cindy, you've got a $30 lead. Cindy, oh, look at this.
Goodbye to the mainland and say hello to the waves of beautiful Hawaii. We'll fly you and a guest via Western Airlines wide-body jet from Los Angeles to Honolulu. You can count on warm hospitality and friendly service in flight, furnished by Western Airlines. Once there, you'll enjoy a week's stay at the Kona Surf, set in tropical gardens, surrounded by the bay, ocean, and a golf course located on Hawaii's Kona Coast. Luxury rooms and island entertainment furnished by Kona Surf. This great trip is normally priced at $2,176. Today on sale of the century, it's yours for only $16.
My goodness. Those are the worst dressed people I've ever seen in my entire life. But the trip to Hawaii, Cindy, have you been there?
Yes.
Yes? Would you like to go back?
Love to.
Over $2,000 trip, $2,176.
Yes.
Now, you would still, it cost $16, you would still have a big lead. You've got a $30 lead. All you have to do is win, and you are $50,000 richer. That's all you have to do is win. Say $16 for the trip to Hawaii, you would still have a $14 lead. You think she should have some spending money if she goes to Hawaii?
Definitely.
Does she look like a big spender?
Yes.
Cindy, very big. Cindy, your lead would be cut to $14, but you'd be off to Hawaii. All you have to do is win, and I would give you, in addition, three, four, five. Am I getting your attention, Cindy?
It's getting there.
Six, seven. Oh, heck, luck with it. I'll get it all to you.
Wow.
$2,000 in cash.
Yeah.
$2,176 trip plus $2,000 in cash, but your leave would be cut to $14. Going once, going twice, and no sail. You think she made the right decision? 50-50 on that one, Cindy. But I'll tell you one thing, if she holds on to this lead, it's $50,000 richer. We'll see if she can do it after this. During that commercial break, I asked Thea, Cindy's husband, Steve, what did you think? And he said, I think I'm going to have a heart attack. That's what he thinks. Cindy told me she's a little wary of that $25 money card, and she didn't want to be trailing by more than $25. Right now, she is ahead by 30. Cindy at 75, Doug at 45, Jasmine at 20. In what island nation did Teddy Roosevelt lead the Rough Riders? Doug?
Puerto Rico.
No. Cuba. Up San Juan Hill in Cuba, and you lose 5 down to 40. More than one quarter of the world's people live in this country. Cindy.
China.
Yeah, more than a billion people. China it is. Cindy, the 80s for the $40 lead. In the movies, he's been the king of comedy and a raging bull. Cindy.
De Niro.
That's right, Robert De Niro it is. And Cindy now stretching it out a little bit. But Jasmine and Doug, if you're going to get close, you might need that $25 money card that Cindy was wary of. It's up there someplace looking for a famous person. I was born in Massachusetts in 1820, the daughter of a Quaker family that believed in the equality of men and women. I supported abolition during the Civil War and was once arrested for voting illegally. When I wore bloomers, they became the symbol of the women's rights movement. With Elizabeth Cady Stanton, I formed Doug.
Susan B. Anthony.
The National Woman's Suffrage Association, you are right. Susan B. Anthony, it is. Doug, big kick of the board for you right now.
Number two.
And behind number two, we have $10.
A bit closer, where are the other two big ones?
Behind the seven and the one.
Doug adds a $10 money card to his score, putting a little bit of pressure on Cindy. As we finish up the game with a speed round, 60 seconds on the clock, please. If Cindy wins, she is $50,000 richer. Cindy at 85, Doug at 50, Jasmine at 20. Good luck. We start the speed round now. What state is nicknamed the Buckeye State? Cindy.
Ohio.
Right. Who is the female lead in the hit movie Mask? Cindy.
Cher.
Right. Complete this threesome. Stop, look, and Doug.
Listen.
Right. What former opera soprano's autobiography is titled Bubbles? Cindy.
Fields.
Right. Who wrote the bestseller Valley of the Dolls? Doug.
Jackson Suzanne.
Right. Name the TV series set in Boston St. Elizabeth Hospital. Cindy.
St. Elsewhere.
Right. What is the capital of Virginia? Cindy.
Raleigh.
Wrong. Name the famous king who wielded the magic sword Excalibur. Cindy.
Arthur.
Right. Kabul is the capital of what Asian nation? Doug.
Turkey.
Wrong. Name the movie in which Simon and Garfunkel sang about Mrs. Cindy.
The graduate.
Right before the buzzer. In degrees, what is the latitude of the equator? Cindy.
Zero.
Right. According to the Bible, who gave the Sermon on the Mount?
Cindy.
Moses.
No. Name the British doctor who created Sherlock Holmes. Cindy.
Conan Doyle.
Right. What epic poem was the 12-book masterpiece for Time Is Up? Cindy, you are 50,000. Congratulations. Jasmine, Doug, thank you. You both got some cash, which is lovely. But Cindy, you did it. Come on up here with me. You took the risk and you did it. Now you can try. Way to go. You and the baby have done very well. Congratulations. Well done. You don't mind if your husband Steve runs up here to congratulate this lady? You guys, congratulations. That is lovely. That's wonderful. You have got a great, great total. We will add up that total with this fine champion who can now relax right after this. Wait a second. The moment is yours. Congratulations. Cindy was saying, I didn't, it's not real, is it? Yes, with her husband, Steve, you were right. She should go for it. Congratulations, she made it.
Thank you.
Who are these people?
This is my mother, Madeline.
You're getting the clock, right?
Yes.
And this must be the sister who is crying.
Oh, yes.
And who's this over here?
That's my brother, Gordy.
Gordy, nice to have you here as well. Before we go, I know you told me something, and I wish you'd share it. You said you, with some of the cash you've won, you wanted to do something
with it. We want to make a nice donation to the children in Africa.
That's nice. That is lovely. Thank you. Done so very well. Cindy is leaving us with the $50,000 in cash, another $10,000 in cash, $3,000, all the prizes, $111,590 in cash and prizes for a great champion. We're going to do it all again next time on Tale of the Century. Bye for now.
Way to go. Way to go. Congratulations.
Congratulations. You guys must have been a nervous wreck out there. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
Members of our studio audience, and some depending contestants, will receive Baco's ad-free, bakery tasty your meal and has no preservatives, no cholesterol, no nitrates, no kidding. And Mr. Freeze Pops, school treat for the whole family in mouth-watering assorted fruit flavors. Remember, Mr. Freeze Pops, refreshingly delicious. Plus, two test easy care paint for easy does of painting in three finishes and many decorated colors from True Value Hardware Stores. And Super Sunrise Cakes, now twin-packed for freshness. Tasty, nutritious, and still only 36 calories. Super Sunrise Cakes instead of bread. Jim Perry's Wardrobe, furnished by Foxy 500. Summer Bartholomew's Wardrobe, furnished by Two Potato. All prices are manufacturer suggested retail value and are correct at the time of recording.
This is John Heater. In just a few moments, he could win $40,000 on Scrabble. A nine-letter word. The clue is, it can make your heart go pitter-pat. It's the crossword game you've played all your life, but never quite like this. And here's your host, Chuck Woolery.
All right, thank you, Charlie. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the television version of everybody's favorite game. Going to meet our Scrabble French champion right now. His name is John Heener. John?
Hey, John. How are you?
Howdy. John has 9 wins. $26,000 so far. He's real good at Scrabble French, and the next time he plays, he's going to be going for $40,000, trying to creep his earnings to $40,000. But first, he's got to go through one of these two folks. They're going to try to spoil him.
He's the marketing director. She's the secretary. From Agoura, California, Craig Isaac. And from Milford, Connecticut, Denise Duguay.
All right. Nice to have you both back with us again today.
Thank
Craig,
you.
How are you?
Great, thanks.
Yeah, tell me about yourself, Craig.
I am a marketing director from Agoura. I just had spent my 8-month anniversary with my wife last night. It was great. And I'm ready to play the game.
All right, great. Nice to have you with us.
Thank you.
Hi, Denise.
Hi, Chuck.
How are you?
I'm great.
Yeah, tell me about yourself, Denise.
Well, I am a secretary, a travel agent, and I play a lot of Scrabble and have a lot of fun.
All right. Well, good. I tell you what, when we left off yesterday, the score was 2-1 in favor of Denise, as a matter of fact. And if you're ready, Craig, we'll start with you, and we'll play Scrabble. You
Sounds
ready?
Great. Let's
All right, we're going to play until someone gets 3 words right. And that player goes on to our Scrabble sprint. They'll have a chance at $40,000 in cash. Take a look at the board as we set up our first game. We're going to be building on the letter E. There are 9 letters in this word. Building on the letter E, 9 letters. The clue is they like to watch. Now, when you think you know the word, hit your buzzer. Don't forget some pink and blue squares because they're worth money, okay? They like to watch, Craig.
Great. How about 9? And a 3, please.
All right, and the end.